March 25, Monday, the Solemnity of the Annunciation of the Lord. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled as what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. May it be done to me. Mary is very young, a village lass without much experience about life. How does one fulfill the task of being the mother of the Son of God? Why not choose someone more qualified and ready and stronger? The answer can only be, it is God's will. It is God's prerogative to choose whomever God wills. The how of it all lies in the power of God that will accompany Mary in the fulfillment of her role.